Good afternoon and welcome to another video. In a slight change of location, today we are in the city of Liverpool in the north of England. For their half-term week, they have a series of 12 works of audiovisual art spread around the city. So we're going to go and find all those tonight. I can see the tat sellers are already out, selling the lit up balls and spinners and all that sort of stuff. We're going to go around the 12 things, have a look and listen, so come with us. First up, we're heading into the courtyard of Liverpool Parish Church to find Nova. This is the first day this trail's on, and it's looking quite busy. I think how this one looks depends on how windy it is. Every so often, there you go, it's just doing it. Every so often it releases a little pulse of theatrical smoke, which at the moment is blowing away from us towards the Liver building. So we might have a look at this one from the side, see how it looks. And the recording of this, I believe, is audio recordings from a NASA satellite. This one is a Eurovision related stage performance area with a microphone in the middle. One good thing about these is that all of them are accessible. On the website, they've listed the accessibility requirements of each one, and they've also provided a description for the blind or partially sighted. And on Sunday and Wednesday, they're also doing quiet hours with reduced light levels, reduced audio volumes for those who struggle with such things. So that's very good. And just the other side of the Museum of Liverpool, there's the next one, which is titled Glow, and is something to do with the cycles of the moon. Well, I don't remember the moon being those colours. Now, what you probably can't hear, because you've only got this in mono, is that different sounds are coming from different places. So on some of them, like this one, there is a speaker at the bottom, and this one, when you press the button on it, makes noise. So the overall artwork is related to when people press the buttons. Whereas some, like this one, have no speaker at the base, so when you press the button here, all it does is change the lights and not the sound. This one looks like it's indoors, but I'm not entirely sure if this is indoors or outdoors. I'm not entirely sure what this building is, to be honest. dark like this, you could so easily mistake that exit, which is a bit of glass, for that exit, which isn't. You're not walking into a bit of glass, which would be painful. I don't think this is part of the River of Light, but we have found some lights on the river. It appears to be a couple of long canoes with people wearing fairy lights. I'm going to turn around towards us now because they're going to hit a wall in a second, they're not careful. And back off down the dock again. Next into Albert Dock for Ukrainian Dream. When I say it's accessible to a degree. It is Liverpool Docklands, so everything is cobbled and flagstones, so it's not smooth, but with a bit of determination, it is accessible. Ah, this isn't part of it. This just belongs to the Tate here and is here year round. We appear to have found the boats again in Albert Dock. I wonder if it's a charity thing. Or they're just joining in. Because of course I'm a geek, the spot that it's being projected from up here. Oh, it is multiple projectors, I think there's four of them. So there's four projectors up here with some very long throw lenses on them. Down the far end of the docks here to have a look at where it's being projected. You don't get the sound down here, but you can see the detail of the building a bit more. I very much doubt they'll allow us to walk under there where they've turned the lights off, but I think that's actually just the Maritime Museum. There's no cafes and restaurants under that bit.
Yes, what?
Next one is here. We've seen this on another YouTuber's video in London, and now it's here in Liverpool. It's reflective plastic. Now that shape is not there. This is, I can't reach far enough in, mirrors. Mirror there, mirror there, mirror there, and a mirror there. Creates this virtual shape. And then from the outside, it doesn't look anywhere near as cool. It's just a square of LEDs. You don't get that effect in the slightest. We've left just as the music in that one's got nice and bassy. Look, it's doing a proper light show now. But we don't have time to stay at all of them that long, else we won't get around them all before they finish at 9 o'clock tonight. This one appears much less interactive. Oh, they wiggle in the wind, or when people sit on the bases. This one's not got any sound with it apart from people shouting. Come on, do something fun that runs along them. Here we go. We either did or have done a slow TV that took this same bit of route. I don't know what order I'll end up publishing these in, but the next one is up in these gardens, up on the top of the one centre. Oh, or maybe not. Kira will be really annoyed if I brought her up these stairs for no reason. I thought that was one of them, it's not. Okay, it wasn't that. We've just checked the map and I got thoroughly confused by the fact that there are 12 artworks but only 11 locations. So now we're coming up to Derby Square and the Victorian Monument and the first of our inflatable sculptures for the day. That one possibly made it a little more interesting with some theatrical smoke. But quite nice. The trail ends at 9 p.m. Otherwise, I could see some slightly worse for wear people spending an evening in there just chilling in the vibe. Which is probably why it all closes at 9. The next one we can see from here is Town Hall up there, and they've got a heart-shaped glitter ball. I guess the other reason for ending at 9 is that if you're in one of these hotel rooms, you'd be thoroughly fed up with this glitter ball if it was going all night. One of the things I love about glitter balls actually is the speed they go at is quite slow, but the dots they project go so much faster. And the last ones, I think it's two in one location, are around the back of here. Unfortunately, past the roadblocks.
said that, you said no.
This is Elysian and Elysian Arcs, so I think this counts as two, which is what confused me. I think one of them is the shape in the middle. And the other one is the three arcs around the outside. It's like shiny, transparent, bouncy castle material. And with that, it was 9 p.m. and the lights were just about to be switched off. I hope you enjoyed this quick tour of the Liverpool River of Light 2023. If you did, please do consider subscribing for a new video every week. Thank you very much for watching and have a great day.